Spirit of God has been, you know, touching my heart over the years of priesthood. I'm now 44 years of priest almost, and 4 years your bishop. And the reading that has touched me the most, it is been driving the ministry, I think, for us, is Matthew 28. Matthew 28. And the last part of it, and we're going to shift to here in a second, is really an expression to us from Jesus Christ of who we are called to be. Who we are called to be as church and as disciples. And so it became, I think, important for us to do a guide for the whole diocese in terms of a pastoral guide for evangelization for the whole diocese. Because we were slowly but surely giving workshops and getting all kinds of different questions and things that you had to deal with too in your ministry with the Rite of Christian Initiation for adults. Part of where I'm coming from for you as your bishop is first in a spirit of real gratitude. Just gratitude for all of you and all the ministries that you do. And especially those that have been involved in the Rite of Christian Initiation for adults and young adults and children and youth. It is a blessing to us as church. And I was around when the Second Vatican Council happened, and the Rite of Christian Initiation of Adults was really renewed in the church. It existed from the very beginning, but it was renewed in the church. And so the form of it, it took a lot of study to get back to what was the early church doing? You know, what was the pre-evangelization period like? What was the evangelization period like? What was the catechumenate period like? What was the enlightenment period like? What was that moment of the celebration of the sacraments of initiation, that time of calling people to face their own sinfulness and to really receive Jesus Christ and let his healing power touch their lives? And so we do that in the section right before Easter. And then, of course, the Easter sacraments. And then the time of mystagogia. And then the time of being a neophyte. So someone that's a brand new, card-carrying, fully initiated Roman Catholic. And what that looks like for them. Having said that, what was working in the church some 25, 30, 40 years ago is now really something we need to take a hard look at. Because, as you know, we have 85 to 90% of our young people that I just confirmed will disappear from the church in the next 5 years. We also have 75% of the people that we just received into the church through RCIA are going to disappear from the church in 5 years. So there's a message there saying we as a church need to really take a hard look at how we're functioning and how we are bringing people into discipleship, because that's what he asked us to do. And so the reading of Matthew 28 is really special to us. Jesus saying that all power has been given to him. Go therefore and make disciples. That was the first thing he said. Then baptize them in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Then teach them all that I've commanded you, and teach them to know that I'm with you to the end of the age. So those are really the four questions for us in RCIA. Are we making disciples? Are we baptizing all nations? Are we teaching them to do all he's commanded us? And are we letting them know that he's with them to the end of the age? The question, though, comes back to what is it that we need to do to enable going through RCIA to truly become disciples. And I can tell you, when you meet a disciple, you know you met a disciple. You know you met a disciple. And when you met a disciple maker, you really know you met a disciple powerfully. So this particular document we pulled together is meant to be a study guide, but it's also meant to be an opportunity for us to really take a hard look at who we are as a church and begin doing a shift.